Hello everyone, Alex here from warnoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to be showing you three different things in Discord.js. The first of which is how to actually list all of the servers that your Discord bot is inside of and how many members each of them have. The second thing is to bulk delete recent messages inside of a channel and also make sure that only administrators have access to that. And the last thing is to go ahead and update the bot status on the member list. So to get started, I'm going to navigate into my folder. And in the previous video, I made a very basic command handler. In future videos, when we get into more commands or more complicated commands, I'll be creating a much more user-friendly command handler that will work for those use cases. However, for now, this will work for us. And if you want to go ahead and clone everything, the GitHub repository will be in the video description. So going back into index, we're going to create our first command. We're going to pass in the client. We're going to pass in the command name, which is servers. And we're going to get our callback. So what we want to do with this is we want to say client.guilds.cache.foreach. And this is going to give us the ability to loop through all of the guilds. If we call into log each guild and we save this, we can run node index. And this will actually run our bot. We see the client is ready. Going into our testing channel, if we run !servers, we're going to see this console log here that has information on the Warnoff Keys Discord. Now what we want to do is we want to actually send information about this Discord into the channel. So we can say message.channel.send. We're going to use backticks and we're going to say guild.name has a total of guild.memberCount members. If we save this and we restart our bot, we can then go over and run !servers. And we see Warnoff Keys has a total of 30 members. That is how you're going to be able to loop through all of your guilds and get different pieces of information, such as the member count. The next thing we're going to do is we are going to create a command that will clear all recent messages within a channel. So we're going to create a new command. We're going to pass in the client and we're going to have an array. The first thing will be CC for clear channel. The next thing will just be clear channel. And then we're going to have our message callback. So the very first thing we want to do is make sure that the user who's running this is an actual administrator. So if message.member.hasPermission, we pass in a string, in this case it's going to be administrator, then we want to say message.channel.messages.fetch, which is a function, and that's going to return a promise. So when you want to use .then, and this is going to return our messages. However, to not be confused between message and messages, I'm just going to call these results. And we can console log the results. So if we save this and we restart our bot, going into Discord, we can then say !! Clear channel. And we see some information here. If we scroll up, we see !!servers, which will be this top message. If we keep scrolling up, we're going to see the next !!servers. And so we're going to get all the messages here. Now, in order to delete all of these, Discord.js makes that easy. So we could do message.channel.bulk_delete and pass in the results, which is the object that's returned. So if we save this and we run our bot, we can then go in here and do !! Clear channel. And we see that that deleted all of the messages. So the last thing I want to show you guys is how to actually update the status of the bot on the right side member list here. So we're going to create another command for this. We're going to pass in the client, and this will be called status. We're going to get our callback. And the first thing we want to do is we want to get all of the text after the actual command. So, like I mentioned previously, in the future, I will be creating a much better command handler. So for now, we don't have the ability to get all of the non-command text. And by that, I mean if we were to get the content of message.content. In this exact case, if we were to type !! Status hello world, that's exactly what it would return. However, we do not want the !! Status space at the start. So we are actually going to replace that with nothing. So that means that this string would then become hello world. So now that we're going to have access to the actual text after the command and not the command itself, we want to say client.user.setPresence. This is going to pass in an object with an activity, which will be another object. The name will be content. The type will be zero. So if we save this and we restart our bot, we see the client is ready. So going back over here, we can say !!status hello world. Okay, so I've realized I made a simple typo. Contents should have another T there. So if we restart one more time, if we do !!status hello world, we then see it says playing hello world. Of course, we could do exclamation point status test, and it'll update just like that. So that's how you're going to be able to update the status of the bot. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.